episode 1249, Live Life Adventurously.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a
stop sign, watching people. Happy, happy day. It is Motivation Inspiration Day, and I pray that you have a smile on your face because we are going to live life adventurously. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and to sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, mix up your day and live life adventurously. No more mundane, humdrum existence. Stir your heart and live life adventurously. It's time to let down your guard. Be creative in how you choose to lead your life on purpose for your purpose. Today's episode is brought to you by Health, Hope, and Inspiration with Reverend Percy McCray, a podcast created by Cancer Treatment Centers of America to provide cancer care information and resources to the faith-based community. In recent years, there have been some amazing discoveries by the medical community, new techniques and treatments, drugs and therapies. There is hope. Every week on the Health, Hope, and Inspiration podcast, Reverend Percy McCray will inspire you with practical information for your real-life questions about cancer prevention, treatment, and overall healthy living. You'll want to listen in each week by subscribing to the podcast at healthhopeandinspiration.com. What have you tried to do differently to create a different outcome? Most of us are in search of something new, something with more meaning, something with greater impact. However, where we find ourselves is the same position today as we were yesterday. Is that true for you? Think about it. How different is today for you? Look at your schedule than what you did yesterday. Maybe it's just a difference because today is named Tuesday and yesterday was Monday. Maybe it's the weekday and not the weekend, but everything else seems to be the same. How true is it for you? There's no need to fret over spilt milk, but I know how easy it is to stay in that place. I did so many times with my children. The morning milk or sometimes juice, you know, would get knocked over for some strange, odd reason. You know, the dog would jump up or a child would be running through, or we were just running late because mom was just going crazy. And for whatever reason, there goes the milk. And from that point on, the day went downhill. No turning back. How can you ever pull yourself out of the slump? You know, status quo is a slump and we get into it. We get into the rhythm of status quo. I'm okay here. I'm comfortable. If I stretch myself too much, yeah, I don't know. But then comes a drastic situation and you're forced what? To move, to do something different. But when you're in status quo, when you're in that slump, what happens? When you are continuing to perpetuate the situation, you'll stay hunkered down in what is comfortable, even though you desire something different. Today is a new day. This is the day that the Lord has made, and that means it changes. Live life adventurously. For our youngest son's birthday, yes, happy birthday, baby Grayson. I love you so much. Okay, he's not a baby. He's probably going to kill me for telling him happy birthday as baby Grayson. But as a mom, you know they'll always be your babies. It doesn't matter their age. And he's almost as tall as me. We never thought he would hit this growth spurt, but we're absolutely ecstatic for him. And so we thought, what better way than to celebrate with an outdoor adventure park? It was pretty extreme to the point of wearing harnesses throughout the course and everything was done in the trees. I didn't say on the ground, we were in the trees. I must say, go ape. Yes, that's the name of the adventure park. And they're all around the United States. So if you have a group, you know, if your group is made up of children like ages upper elementary to very wise ones like, you know, you and I, go for it. Live life adventurously. I really would recommend it. Now, they have courses that are for younger ones, but there's just something about when they're a little bit older, and especially for the adults, or I would say high schoolers, you know, upper middle school, high school, into your, you know, getting out there, young adult type things. Oh, it's life changing. And reading about what to expect, it was nothing when we arrived on the actual course. Those were really tall trees. And we did multiple zip lines and more zip lines. We climbed rickety ladders. We walked over things that didn't necessarily seem right. And when you look at it and you're standing on one tree and you know you have to get to the next one, and I am not a monkey, I'm sitting there going, there's no way we're going that route. And it was crazy. Now, all of us went as a family, except our oldest son. He was working at his summer internship with his job. And what amazement to watch each of my children realize their greater potential. Strength meant nothing to them until they were pushed to their limits and they succeeded with flying colors beyond their limits. It was absolutely incredible to watch them. My Einstein, who's a junior now in high school, oh my goodness. He's like, Mom, I've got noodly arms, but look at what I'm doing. At one point in the course, you could choose moderate or extreme level. He chose extreme every time. And I was like, if he's going extreme, that means this mama life coach has got to go extreme too. And I thought, I really don't want to go extreme. I did two Tarzan things where you get, you're harnessed in. So there's safety here. Understand that. But you don't know what's going to happen. We were strapped into one of these Tarzan events, and you literally just sit down and you're flying yourself into a net. Nope, nothing below you, but people walking around looking up. It's a park outside. I'm like, what if I fall down? I could have come up with 1,000 excuses not to do this. In fact, when I was sitting there at the last Tarzan net, I asked the sweet lady down below me, which was feet and feet and feet. I don't know how many feet. Too many feet below me. And I yelled down to her. I said, do I really have to do this? And she said, yes, you do. Live life adventurously. I share this with you today to say, stop living within your own limits. Live life adventurously. There is so much more to your purpose in life that limits only shut out possibilities. See what you can do by pushing beyond what you can see. Stir your heart and believe that you can live your dream. Your strength is found not in what you know, but in what you learn when tested beyond your own limits. Make each day an historic, life-changing event. Live life adventurously. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.